Follow the sun. Misjudging sunlight is a common pitfall when you're first learning to garden. Pay attention to how sunlight plays through your yard before choosing a spot for your garden. Most edible plants, including many vegetables, herbs, and fruits, need at least 6 hours of sun in order to thrive. Stay close to water. One of the best gardening tips you'll ever get is to plan your new garden near a water source. Make sure you can run a hose to your garden site, so you don't have to lug water to it each time your plants get thirsty. The best way to tell if plants need watering is to push a finger an inch down into the soil, that's about one knuckle deep. If it's dry, it's time to water. Start with great soil. When starting a garden, one of the top pieces of advice is to invest in soil that is nutrient-rich and well-drained. Achieve this just right blend by mixing 3 inches of Miracle-Gro all-purpose garden soil into the top 6 to 8 inches of existing soil if you're planning to plant in the ground. If you're planting in a raised bed, use Miracle-Gro raised bed soil, which is the perfect weight and texture for raised bed growing. Consider containers. When space is at a premium, look to containers. You can grow many plants in pots, including vegetables, herbs, flowers, fruit trees, berries, and shrubs. When gardening in containers, use a pot that's large enough for the plant it's hosting, and fill it with Miracle-Gro Moisture Control Potting Mix. Not only is it specially formulated to help plants in pots thrive, but it also helps protect against over and under watering. Choose the right plants. It's important to select plants that match your growing conditions. This means putting sun-loving plants into a sunny spot, choosing heat-tolerant plants in warm climates, and giving ground-gobbling vines like pumpkins and melons ample elbow room, or a trellis to climb. Do your homework and pick varieties that will grow well where you live and in the space you have. And to get a step up on success when growing veggies and herbs, start with vigorous young plants from Bonnie Plants instead of trying to grow from seed. Discover your zone. Knowing your hardiness zone can help you choose the best plants. Simply put, it describes the coldest place a plant can grow. The higher the zone number, the warmer the climate. So if a plant is hardy to zone 4 and you garden in zone 5, that plant will survive in your yard. If, however, you're in zone 3, it's too cold to grow that particular plant. Find out your hardiness zone. Learn your frost dates. Planting too early, or late, in the season can spell disaster for your garden. You need to know the last average spring frost date for your area so you don't accidentally kill plants by putting them out prematurely. It's also good to know your first average fall frost date so that you get your plants harvested or moved indoors before late season cold damages them. Discover the average first and last frost dates for your area. Add some mulch. Apply a layer of mulch that's 2 to 3 inches deep around each plant. This will help reduce weeds by blocking out the sun, and reduce moisture loss through evaporation, so you have to water less. For a polished look, put down a layer of Scott's bag mulch. Or, you can put down straw, shredded leaves, pine straw, or some other locally available material. Add some mulch. Add some mulch. Apply a layer of mulch that's 2 to 3 inches deep around each plant. This will help reduce weeds by blocking out the sun, and reduce moisture loss through evaporation, so you have to water less. For a polished look, put down a layer of Scott's bag mulch. Or, you can put down straw, shredded leaves, pine straw, or some other locally available material. How to start a garden? Want to learn how to start a garden, but not sure where to begin? In this post, I'll cover the basics of gardening, and provide links to more detailed information so you can garden with confidence and have fun doing it. Get ready to enjoy some of the best tasting fruits, vegetables and herbs you've even eaten. How to start a garden, 10 basic steps. Decide what you'd like to grow. Choose a location. Plan your garden beds. Invest in basic garden tools. Test your soil. Prepare the soil. Choose the right seeds or transplants. Plant with care. Nurture your garden. Enjoy your harvest. Number 1, decide what you'd like to grow in your home garden. Rule number 1, if you won't eat a crop, don't grow it in your vegetable garden. I break this rule for flowers. Edible or not, I like to see at least a few in every garden, focus on the fruits, vegetables or herbs that your family enjoys the most. Make sure your top choices make sense for your area. Figure out your gardening zone and estimated first and last frost dates. If possible, talk to successful gardeners in your area to find out which crops grow well and which don't. In my northern garden, crops that take over 100 days to mature or high temps are a gamble. For example, we enjoy watermelons, but I stick to varieties like Blacktail Mountain, 70 days, instead of Carolina Cross, 90 days. My southern gardening friend, Amber, has challenges with crops like peas, which prefer cooler temperatures, and vine crops like cucumbers, which are prone to mildew and high humidity. If you only want a small garden, don't attempt to grow something like a giant pumpkin, which will spread over a very large area. Do you want to plan for storage vegetables, or only enough to eat fresh? It's probably best to start your garden mainly with fresh eating in mind, but some vegetables are extremely easy to store. See the 5 easiest vegetables to store for more information. Number 2, choose a location to start your garden. Most fruits and vegetables need full sun, with a minimum of 5 hours of direct sunlight per day for fruiting. Greens, herbs and root veggies will grow in partial shade. Southern gardens may benefit from late afternoon shade, whereas northern gardens likely need all the sun they can get. Think about how you will access the garden for picking, watering and caring for your plants. Out of sight often equals out of mind, and a neglected garden. Avoid high wind areas and frost pockets, low areas where frost is likely to settle. Watch out for wildlife, pet damage and children's play areas. When we first moved here, our neighbor's dog would randomly visit and dash through the garden. This was very hard on new seedlings. Now the dog is gone, but the deer and wild bunnies come to visit, so we plan accordingly. See Keep Deer Out of Your Garden, 5 Deer Deterrent Strategies and 6 Ways to Use Garlic in the Garden for tips. For more ideas on gardening in limited space, see Small Garden, Big Yield, 10 Tips for a Great Harvest. 3. Plan your garden beds. Once you know where you want your garden, decide on the type and size of garden beds. Raised beds are attractive and may make it easier to work in your garden, but they also dry out more quickly. In very dry areas, sunken beds can be used to gather available moisture. Think about planting your garden in blocks or beds of plants instead of single rows. Beds should be 3 to 4 feet across, narrow enough that you can reach the center from either side. Beds should be roughly 10 feet long or less, so you're not tempted to step into the bed and compact the ground. Within the garden beds, place plants in rows or a grid pattern. The goal is minimize walkways and maximize growing space. You only add fertilizer and soil amendments to the planting area, which saves time and money. Work with companion plants to attract beneficial insects and improve yields.